Quinn, mm-hmm. he was here. You were going to come in the tournament, and he was both there. What was that like for you to see him lead the team?
I like to do a lot. You know, he's cool. Cool to be around. He can throw the ball, but he just thought what the best of him was somewhere else. So just respect him. Go on.
What was it that made staying committed to Ohio State and coming here best for you?
Just Coach Hartline, the offense. I mean, Ohio State's always going to have a QB. So.
I'm guessing you got a chance to watch the Rose Bowl.
Yeah.
How much do you envision yourself doing something like what Jackson did in that game? Mm-hmm. And how much does that make you motivated to come here and to do something like that right out the gate?
Yeah, definitely. He bought out that game. But hopefully I'll be doing that in the next couple of years.
What's the first steps to getting there?
Just working hard every day. Just becoming the best version of myself every day.
That's it. You got to test slow down again?
Yes.
I do. Rest you about this.
He can throw. It's beautiful. It comes out, looks effortlessly. He can throw far too fast. He was throwing the ball 40 yards and straight drive. Kind of hurt the catch.
Y'all have to tell, Keon kind of said the same thing. He throws it hard. You guys have to tell him to kind of
Nah, we don't ever tell him to slow it down. He can throw it.
Is there a specific moment in the recruiting process where you realized that Ohio State was the place for you?
It was kind of just a building relationship thing. You know, what stood out was Coach Hartline. He didn't, most coaches don't call just off you on the first day, not even try to talk to you again. Just because, the name of the program, but it wasn't like that. You know, he got to know me for about a couple months, maybe 4 or 5 months before he got to offer me, so that probably stood out.
What were maybe the things about him that he did in that process that made you feel comfortable with him, beyond just with the
Just calling and checking in with me, weekly, talking with my parents, my sister, and just building, an overall good relationship with everyone that supports me and everyone that's around me.
Does that make it easier when you're going far away from home that you know what the offense is already?
Yes, sure.
Chris Olave talked about how important it was for him to leave California and do his own thing. Is that kind of what played in your decision-making process of going away from home? Yeah. Chris talked about going away from California and how much that shaped him to do his own thing, be his own person. How much did that motivate you to maybe leave Texas and do your own thing here in Ohio?
It motivated me a lot. My dad's from Houston. He played college ball at Syracuse. So he was pretty far. My parents kind of wanted me to go pretty far. It's just also like a learning thing. Just not having, parents to go run to. If I was at Texas, parents to go run to, that's 15 minutes away from the house. So, I kind of like the movie. Being far away.
Did your dad tell you about his experience, what he got out of that, of going to Syracuse, doing something different?
Yes.
And what did he say to you about
that? He was just saying, it's just a good way to mature and learn. It's a good way to grow up. I mean, there's going to be
adversity. Appreciate you.
Describe your game a little bit out there, Caleb. What do you do well? Just kind of describe your game out there.
I think I run routes well. I think I break down good. It's something I'm working on, just breaking out, rolling out of routes, yards after the catch, getting stronger. So it's all going to come.
I know it's early. Couldn't be any earlier. But what are your, generally speaking, what are your expectations for the rest of the season?
Just do what I can to help the team, special teams, offense. I'm just here to put in work.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
I think I am.